Well, a very good evening, everybody, and welcome back to the Imagine Cruising 2024 World Indoor Bowls Championships. We're live at Potter's Resort in Hopton-on-Sea. Well, we have another cracking game for this evening in the ladies' match play. Lauren Garren against Julie Forrest. It looks like people are almost ready here in the International Arena, so we're going to go to our very own MC. Please give it a massive round of applause, Jack Jenkins.
Thank you very much, Jason. Yes, an ugly crowd in here in the International Arena. The first of our players out for this evening's match, we have a former World Mixed Pairs champion and two times previous winner of this event. Please welcome out Scotland's Julie Forrest. Her opponent this evening is a former National and British Isles champion, making her debut here in the World Championship competition from Wales. Give it up for Lauren Gowen!
I feel glorious!
Hand you up to Jason Parkinson and Kerri-Anne Glenn in the commentary box.
Thank you very much, Jack. Once again, good evening, everybody. Welcome back here to the Imagine Cruising World Indoor Bowls Championships. As Jack has just said there, joining me for this one is Kerri-Anne Glenn. Good evening, Kerri.
Hi, everyone. Hi, Jason.
What's occurred in?
Oh, let's see what happens in this game. This should be a real cracker. Really looking forward to it.
Jack length, 26 metres.
Julie Forrest in green here. Well, she's one of the most decorated bowls players there is. She's been around a long, long time, been there, done it, seen it, but she's done it with a little bit of class and, you know, she's very well grounded, isn't she?
It's unbelievable, Jason, like, unbelievable amount of titles and across lots of different courts as well. You know, it's not just here at Potter's. Plenty of WIBC World titles as well for Julie, British Isles titles, multiple Scottish titles. Yeah, she's a real class act. Great start, Lauren.
Lauren Garren here, the PBA qualifier. Plays in Wales, qualified out of the Desborough Maidenhead Club, which is very close to Heathrow Airport, to be fair. Do you know a lot about Lauren coming from Wales?
I know a little about Lauren. Amazingly talented, a real up-and-coming star, not just in Wales, but in the sport, actually. From Taffeely Bowls Club, her hometown's Tonopandy. Hi, everyone in Tonopandy. Hi, everyone in Wales that's tuning in to support our Lauren. And yeah, it's just been lovely watching her perform, actually, and settle in here in Potter's. She should be really proud of herself. She's handled herself really, really well. And I would expect her to give Julie some game tonight. This should be a real class game.
As you can tell, I've got Kerri in the box this evening for all those Welsh pronunciations, because I'd have really made a mess of those. Julie Forrest, well, she's playing with yet again, another player playing with the birds. You played with the birds?
I did. But I think the birds will be flying better for Julie tonight than they did for me earlier.
I thought you flung them over the cliff.
Exactly. They were for the birds, those birds, this afternoon.
Now, Lauren Garren, she's playing with a new mate to the portable surface this year. She's playing with what we call, it's called biased bowls. It's actually made by the Taylor Company. I was speaking to Lauren. I've never actually sent a bias bowl, but looks like they're in between a Taylor Ace and a Taylor International.
I think they're very similar to an ace, but Lauren's left-handed, and I suppose that will change a little bit how they look coming up the green, so they're kind of running more like an international for her. But Yeah, I mean, it's all really about finding centering, and Lauren's been doing that really, really well, both in practice, but also in her mixed pairs when she played with Paul.
For those of you tuning in on Facebook or YouTube and want to ask Kerri-Anne a question, it's always great to get a female in the box, especially one of the players. Just pop it in the chat function and we'll try and answer them the best we can.
One shot, Julie Forrest.
Well, there's Julie's daughter, Alex.
0-1, first
end. She's a massive supporter of her mum. It's great to see. So pretty, isn't she? She really is.
She's a bonnie lassie.
That's what you call it, a bonnie lassie. Yeah, she really is.
But on both fronts, not just to look at Jason. She's a lovely, lovely girl. And, you know, she's our mum's daughter. So we would expect that.
That length, 27 and a half metres.
Again, two very good opening bowls. You just see there the little slightly different design on the bias bowls. The number 22 there on Lauren's bowl, that's the date of the month her birthday is.
Yeah, Laura was talking to you about it. She said that when they manufacture, they put the numbers on the bowls.
Yeah.
It's quite a nice approach. I quite like
it's
that.
It's a little bit like sports car racing. If you look at their design, their shirts that they do, the numbers, it's very Italian Grand Prix, bit Herbie Goes Bananas kind of thing, but I like it.
The Australian team, when they get capped, they put the numbers on their
yes,
caps.
Yes, I like that as well.
And it's kind of a similar approach, like these are my 22s, I'm 22. I like that. Two little ducks there.
Yes.
Disappointed in that one. Looks a good line to me. She's just over.
Yeah, just slightly overplayed.
Now, this could be my judgment, Jason, but when I was out there this afternoon, I felt the carpet was running around a second and a half quicker than at any stage in the last week. It's really interesting because what we normally find is the carpet slackens off as the tournament progresses, but for my game it was very hot and it was very quick, and it was quite interesting that the hands changed so much. And you see it a little bit here with Julie, that she's such a good player with the first two bowls, and she's picked her length, she's put the jack down, and she's run by with a couple of balls. Here we are. Look, she's adjusted brilliantly here. Wonderful. Well played, Julie. But, you know, I'm not surprised that there's a little bit of settling down time here, because I think the rink really has changed.
It was a busy afternoon, wasn't it? I mean, people are still just out having dinner this evening. They'll come back in slowly.
Oh, Lauren, you're close.
One shot, Julie Forrest.
So
set score 0-2 after two ends.
So two singles for Julie Forrest. Quick question for you, Kerri. What was the portable rink like today, which you've mentioned compared to what it was when the first time you played many, many years ago. Sorry for saying that.
No, it's fine. It's been a long time ago I was here. Great question. Today was the first time I've played on it since I've arrived last week, where it was really quite similar to 2008. And it could have just been my judgment. I might have been having a hot flush, but it felt really quite quick, and it had good finish on it. Apart from on the short lengths, I felt the forehands were sticking out a little bit. But overall, as closest to 2008 that I've seen this week so far. When I first arrived, I felt it wasn't running that great. I felt it wasn't finishing so well. And that when the air conditioning was coming on, that it was kind of dying. The rink was dying, the balls weren't turning much. But this afternoon, it felt good. And long may continue. Hopefully, they'll just keep the heat on for the rest of the tournament. Obviously, they have to control the temperature because there's a crowd in here. They can't sweat too much. But that was as good as I've seen it this afternoon.
A little bit of an adjustment there, still 18 inches. Down a very narrow line, still lacking just that little bit of pace. As obviously, for those of you watching that play, probably most of your league games in the evening, you'll certainly notice, obviously it's 7:45 here. Most league games start 6, upper 6. You'll notice halfway through your league game how the green changes. Now, that's what's going to happen here. You know, it's the same bays, it's the same carpet. I always say it's the first player to adapt quicker.
I would say so, yeah. It's interesting to see these. I know these girls. These are world-class players. Both of them are incredible draw bowlers. And so for there to be this much room is an indication the rink A has changed, B quite settled yet.
One rep.
If you are out there though and you're looking at that and you think, I can do better than that, I would say fantastic. Enter the qualifiers, come forward. There will be qualifiers next year in England and I think also in Wales.
Yeah, we're looking at a Wales event, yep.
So if you're out there and you think, I can have a go at this, I can do this, great. Come forward, do the qualifier, and this could be you next year.
There's so many ladies that say, I don't think I'm good enough. I really don't think I'm good enough. How do you know if you don't give yourself a chance?
Oh, I'd say just watch my game. You'll soon feel good enough.
You said it.
Well done, Lauren. Oh, that's fantastic. Look at that. She's gone right across the head with the first two and then bang on it with two.
Two shots to Lauren.
That'll settle her down.
It will.
So that's called 2-2 after three ends.
I think Lauren is very similar to Nicole Rogers. I mean, I've tipped Nicole for the last couple of years. I think she is the next Catherine Reddell. I think she has all the shots in the book. I never recognise her because every time I see her, she's got a different hair colour. That's you ladies, no?
You don't have that problem, Jason.
Just buy it.
That length, 27.5 metres.
I think it's really easy to draw comparisons. The one thing I would say about Lauren is she's really shown what a quality, world-class lead she can be for Wales. However, she's got all the shots and she shows that through her singles play and she has skipped for Wales junior level. She's captain of the country junior level. So, you know, she's going to go all the way and there's absolutely nothing stopping her. She's got the temperament. She's calm. She actually loves being on the cameras. I could see her when I practiced with her the other night and I said, oh, look at all the BBC rigging. And she was like, great. and I do think there's players that come here and they either rise to that or they panic. and Lauren is not a panicker. So I would be unsurprised also to see her and Nicole Rogers in future in many finals.
This, two exceptionally good bowls. You don't get this much of a chance from Julie. Lauren really needs to just keep applying the pressure. When you're playing the top class players, all you need to do is just keep applying the pressure. Julie will be used to that pressure, but it's how she deals with it.
Good. You have to remember, Lauren is just 20 years old. She's skipping up the green near our potters, absolutely loving this.
And so she should.
Yeah.
Three red.
And we say that to all the qualifiers, whether you win or lose, just enjoy the experience. Because if you enjoy it, the pressure's already off you. Just not getting back again, just slightly overplayed. So Lauren will have to decide here, do I go again to make a four? Or do I cover the back? And I think three at this stage is okay. You know, you can't write Julia Forrest off, I'm hitting that. I think she just needs to maybe go slightly deep, 4 feet, 5 feet past the head.
You're right, they're the two options. Yeah, the other option is you tuck the jack in, but you'd have to be on real top form to back yourself for that. I think she will go deep.
The line's certainly saying she's going slightly past. Yeah, that's a good bowl.
Julie will probably like the forehand runner. Julie's forehand runners are really great. You want to close your eyes when you're playing against her when it looks like she's going to run on her forehand. Here she goes.
Oh, just a bowl tight, that was all. So a great three for Lauren.
Three shots, Lauren Gowen. Set score 5-2 after four ends. Length 27.5 meters.
Well played, Julie. Here's a quick question for you, Kerri-Ann. Lindsay Gretchen.
Oh, Lindsay, hi. Yeah.
You know, fabulous player in her own right as well, isn't she?
Incredible.
Yeah. Yeah. From a good family as well.
Oh, amazing. Her daughter's done so well as well. Hi, Lindsay.
The question is, why is there so few women in comparison to the men at top level?
Well, great question, Lindsay. I think you already know the answer to this because you're awesome in your own right. Okay, so I think it's to do with pathways. I was really fortunate, as was Lindsay, when I was a young girl, to be in the same club as John Price, and I got to watch and play with a lot of men. And so the style of play was different. So I learned the sport in a different way. And so I've been fortunate that way. But I would say that having come here and qualified for the men's singles and played against the men, the one thing I felt was that they've always had access to really top level competition, more competition right from junior level all the way through. And so the comparative experience between men and women, when it gets to the elite level, there's a significant gap. So I don't think there's a gap in talent. I think there's a gap in exposure to the appropriate competition levels. And so that's one of the reasons I think we've still got a women's match play in addition to the open singles. Because unless the sport's really prepared to address the differential in what men and women both have access to right through the pathway, then we need to give women the opportunity to have this additional competition. I think it supports the build the different addressing that gap a little bit.
Yep. Going nice and quick. Ooh, pulled that. That seems to go very quick.
You know, Lawrence missed that, but I like to see that. Like, she didn't mess about. She didn't play a little runner. She didn't faff about. She just got ripped it right through. And, you know, she missed it, but she went for it. And maybe she could have drawn it. But, you know, it's tough out there, guys, to draw within a few inches. And it is a draw-drive game, essentially.
It's what your confidence is at the time, isn't it?
Yeah. And I hope she's not standing out there thinking, oh, maybe I missed too much. You can't think like that. Really got to just go for it.
Two green.
Two shots, Julie Forrest. Set score 5-4 after five ends.
Interesting to see what Julie does with the lens here, because they've both been succeeding on each other's lens. Also interesting that Julie's going forehand. Generally, I think what the players are saying is they prefer backhand on longer lens and forehand on a short lens. But of course, you can't keep swapping sides at some point, you know, particularly leading off. You've got to commit one way or another. And of course, I feel like the rink has changed out there today. But Julie's opting for forehand, and she's brought the mat up a little bit. So I'll be interested to see what happens here. Whether Lauren can beat Julie on her own length again.
Three feet short of Jack High.
Great adjustment. Seen these kind of ends a few times, Kerry. For most bowlers, you can understand this. How many times do you play a great league game where you're playing 10 great ends and three ends you go a walkabout all of a sudden and you don't know why or what's caused that?
Yeah, so it can be a concentration dip, right? But having been out there myself, struggling on this very carpet, on this very lens, what I try and communicate to people is the way the portable ring works is that when you bring that mat up or you change the lens, the lines change. And of course they change. But with the portable ring, when you're on a different line, it is a different weight. It's obviously got a new underlay as well this year. So it can make you look foolish really fast. And of course, so this year, I think more than any year that I've seen here, the winner will be the one that mentally copes with the fact the ring is constantly changing and different lengths and different lines and different weights. Rather than aiming for perfection, you know, just getting the win is good enough.
Time I call.
So I think that makes it more interesting, actually. We've got to see people's character come out. Flooding the jack is not much of an option this year, I think. Fantastic group in there. Well done, Julie. That was superb.
Slight
target, though.
Three shots, Julie Forrest. Set score 5-7 after 6 ends.
Costly end there for Lauren. That said, still well within touching distance in this set here. I think overall she'd be quite pleased to be in the spot
and a half meters.
On two back.
One red.
Well, just slightly overplayed, but that's not too bad.
See a few names coming through. People saying, hello, Kerry. Hi, Kerry. Just hi, everybody. Anyone that's saying hello, hello. Hope you've really been enjoying the coverage. I think it's been superb. I think we'll all agree what a great job Jason and team have done. I personally loved listening to Alex, Paul, Darren, Stuart, all the players coming in, giving their views. I always find it fascinating. I've been playing the sport since I was a baby, but every time people like Darren get in the commentary box, I learn something new. I'm sure you'd all agree. It's been absolutely fantastic. And credit to Jason opening things up and getting everyone involved.
It's just a case of offering something different. I mean, because the championships, they're on for so long. Nobody wants to listen to me drone on, you know, 12 hours a day for 3 weeks. And I just think we just want to offer something different. For me, the great thing was when Greg was playing Alex, there's a massive battle on the green, but then we also had kind of like Nicky and Paul Foster in the commentary box.
Yes.
I think it was like a battle in the commentary box as well. And I said to them, I don't suppose you fancy doing the commentary together, thinking, and all the players, the last couple of years, all the top 16 players and the qualifiers, they're all buying in.
Yes.
So bravo to them. Thank you very much. Yeah. And I hope people enjoy that.
Big end here for Lauren. Add another here.
If she's good pace, she gets right around the
back. Yeah, back. Oh, it's a flop. Maybe.
Just a one.
One shot, Lauren Gowen.
Yep, just the one.
Well, absolutely fascinating first set so far. I know both ladies will be wanting to get more of their balls closer, as we all would, right? But I'm so impressed with Lauren. She's so composed out there and not getting too frustrated with the odd stray ball. And she's had two drives that have missed, but she's gone for it. And you've just got to go for your shots out there. And the gap in experience between these two ladies
28
is
and a half meters.
Vast, and yet the gap in talent is minor. So let's see who comes out on top here.
So almost a full length, just a meter short of the 29 and a half meters. First ball, well, it's going to be within 2 feet. Bad at all. Fantastic.
Wonderful bowling.
Just not going to make the trip, I don't think. Just 18 inches or so.
Julie can really afford to be positive here. Nothing short. How's she looking? Oh, I think she'd be a bit disappointed with that. Just short.
Again, it's 18 inches, maybe just slightly nip the line. When we say nip the line, you're probably talking an inch and a half.
Yeah, you're absolutely right. It's a dead draw, but even if Julie had passed there and stayed wide, she may have had a backhand shot on, because dropping a one here is really just a one-end shootout then. And yet the way the head's set up, if Lauren can drop another one in here, balls would be relatively well protected. So can Lauren take the opportunity? No.
Just that yard.
Yep. So Julie's got a dead draw on here. Not an easy shot.
Again, just not being up ever so slightly short.
Probably just short. I mean, it's the line, down. Really, that she missed. I mean, the wider line to cut her anyway. If she'd taken a little bit more grass there,
she'd have 7-7 off 8 ends.
I'm sure. Nailed that.
So, into the last end of this first set. It's a one-end shootout. We played like a tiebreak, Kerry, yeah?
Yes.
Nice and positive.
Nice and positive. I'm sure both women will be. I'm just looking at the way the ball's reacting here, and I am wondering, with the crowd being a little more sparse tonight, I'm not sure why, whether this carpet started to drop off.
Jack, 28 and a half.
Maybe that's why we're seeing Julie just miss a little bit there, a little bit tight, a little bit short.
Lauren stands right on the very back of the mat. You don't see that very often, do you?
No, you don't. No, you don't. It's really solid delivery.
How short was that, Neil?
20-inch gap.
Show it.
Julie makes me laugh. She's from... It's pronounced Hoik.
From Hoik, yeah.
Spelt Hoik, in my opinion.
Yeah, they're incredibly proud of her there, and absolutely rightly so. She's got her indoor stadium named after her, and I know everyone will be behind her, not just in Hoik, but across Scotland. And she's been such a fantastic ambassador for Scottish bowls for so long. And she's a Scottish captain indoor at British Isles level. I know why. Not only is she a fantastic player, but she's inspiring and she's easy to talk to, very approachable. She takes no nonsense from the team. That they'll respect her. When Julie speaks, people listen.
So they should.
She's earned the right to be listened to, for sure. But she talks sense as well. She doesn't, not like me, she doesn't talk nonsense.
That's why I've got you turned down.
Thank you, Jason. It's a Welsh thing. We love to chat, us Welsh girls.
I just turned you down slightly left here.
Again, just tight and a little short. I do think this carpet might be dropping off a little bit, but it's whoever adjusts to it first. It's the same for both players.
So a really good ball here from Lauren could put Julie in an awful lot of trouble.
He could.
Nice front toucher would be disastrous for Julie. Nothing past the jack.
I'll tell you what, she ain't far off yet.
Three red.
So Julie might try and open this up a bit, Jace, rather than just dead drawing it.
Yes.
Because, you know, she's not managing to slide around.
The trouble is, when you play a dead draw, it's 100% accuracy or nothing.
Yeah.
I mean,
Julie's capable of it, for sure. But right now, on this evening, on this carpet,
Julie has 2 time-outs
I wonder if the percentage is just to rip this head open, create some space. She could definitely get the 2 balls. If she's lucky, she could get the 3. But worst case scenario, she's going to make some room for herself.
Man, she's playing forehand. I thought if she's playing the runner, she may have played the backhand. I think she might be drawing this, no?
No. Yeah. She might.
No, yeah. You're going to go for it again?
There we go. Like, what do I know? She's, tell you what, she's...
drawn it.
No. She's dipping again. This is what that hand is doing. There is a little bit of test and learn, right? But, you know, you've tested it. And again, she's a ball wider. She would have nailed that.
Yeah. I mean, so here, if you look at that camera angle there from the other end, I think that Julie doesn't have a shot anymore other than the draw. Now, if Lauren can play the forehand draw and finish 3, 6, 7 inches in front of the jack on the forehand, that is nearly...
possible.
Unbeatable.
Yeah. It's got to be positive. She does not want to be sitting jack high. Oh, Lauren.
She sits side by side.
Needs to miss it.
Oh,
there she
fabulous.
Is. Wow. Wow.
Well played, Lauren. Four great balls. Asking the questions of Julie.
My ears are hurting. I can actually hear whales screaming from here.
Can you?
Yeah, I can. I can hear them in the hillsides, hear them in the vales.
Yeah. It's not sound of music.
Right, Julie, what have you got?
Hits and hope, I think.
Yes. And stun runs through.
Oh!
Wow, Julie, what
three
a
shots, first set, long gone.
Well, that's three shots for Lauren. And to be fair, that's fantastic play from Lauren. I mean, like you say, 20 years of age, she's playing one of the best players there's ever seen on this portal, right?
Yep.
And she's doing very well. So this is where when you win the first set, sometimes, would you agree, you can just slightly relax thinking, well, at least I'm guaranteed a tie break.
I think that's
forward.
A risk. That's always a risk for any player. But less so for Lauren. She's a bit of a machine that way, I think. I would say I'd be more likely to wander in terms of my concentration than this youngster. But what we can't discount is Julie's experience here. She has depths to pull from, and I still wouldn't want to put any money on the winner here.
Do you have splinters? Sat on the fence?
To be honest, I wasn't sat on the fence because although Lauren is a fellow Welsh player and I desperately love to see her succeed here and build her career here on the portable rink, you know, you'd have to look at the odds of being in Julie's favour with all her experience and also the way she's been playing this week. She's been exceptional. So if anything, I would have come into this game thinking, yeah, I would have to be honest and say that Julie would start further it. But here we go. The young Welsh girl is showing what she's made of. Not just slid through the first set, but really taking it. She dropped that 1-3. And with that as the exception, you know, a pretty solid performance right through that set.
One green. One red.
Close, Julie. Very, very good.
Oh, brilliant.
Waterfall.
A little touch on the jack, I think, maybe just enough. Look at this. Touch off the green ball, back in. Very unlucky. Good ball, though.
Excellent ball. It's quite tough on our hand. It's all about absolutely perfect weight. Sorry,
and declare it, one shot, Julie Forrest.
Played that really well, actually.
Chicken Julie. Julie's saying, oh, there's too much danger there for me, so I'm going to declare the end. Take the one
shot. 0-1, first end.
Chose not to send her last ball, and that's totally acceptable. Someone clapped the umpire then from sending the ball.
Did they?
Yeah. Better delivery than I have. My delivery this year is like the midwife. Lots of complications.
Oh, jeez.
My delivery is terrible.
I don't know what's going on with my delivery.
Umpires here have been terrific for so many years, and I had a privilege of catching up with them just the other day. I'm picking their brains on how the best umpiring courses work, how the best umpiring systems work, what Will Bowles is looking to do. And I also done some interviews with them, so talked about what inspired them to get involved in umpiring. And if any of you are watching tonight and thinking about becoming an umpire or a marker, I would just encourage you just to go for it. You know, we don't have our sport without our officials
at all.
We just couldn't do it without them, and it's a fantastic way to become a better bowler as well, to understand the rules, understand how we best use them. So yeah, if you're out there and you're just thinking, I want to do that, just do it. Great start from Julie here, changing up the length, gone short, and now she started to group.
Laura just played the same. I mean, anything just over the pace inside her own, even if she lifts her own, it's going to be slightly better, but certainly just inside, bowl or jack, this isn't going to be far away. Even if she just gets back to the back green bowl.
She's just overplayed that.
That gives herself another option, though,
yeah,
doesn't it?
It does.
Short balls at top level are just the scourge of the game, aren't they?
Yes, they are. I keep saying to myself. Look at this. So this is where the class steps in. You know,
three green.
I take a chance at that. I got nice and positive. There's a wide bowl of Lauren's that she can use.
This is where it's a test, because on this carpet, the stuff you normally play in your clubs, everyone listening, you'd have a little run at that, right? You overplay the shot. Here, those shots don't work. They either hang by or they sail under the head. And you can see Laura's just sailing by there. At club, in your clubs, that would have just come back. And she gave it a chance. It's a great weight. This is where you kind of go, you're better off just whacking it.
Yeah. Very technical there.
Yeah, very technical. Whack it.
See, you're a head coach.
Yeah.
Just whack it.
Yeah, but really, she gets the front ball. She gets the two of them, right?
Yes.
It's very difficult to play that controlled weight here. She doesn't have another ball now. Is the last one, so let's keep this tight. If you can get second out of this, that would be a good result.
Just a ball wide.
Yeah,
that's all it was.
You see, she's trying to do the right thing there, and you have an accident, you drop a three. These are the things that show in the experience.
Three shots, Julie Forrest.
And she'll learn from that. She'll watch this back.
Set score 0-4 after two ends.
Well, Julie was loving that short one. I'd be surprised if she doesn't do it again. bit longer.
Probably a yard.
That length, 26 metres.
Maybe she's just playing different lengths, different directions. I'm not sure yet. She hasn't really played the same length once in this game. It's been a different length jack pretty much every time Julie's thrown it. So it's really difficult to then settle. All right, albeit it's only a yard more, but the position of the mat's different, the position of the jack's different, it makes it hard. Not really some section. But look, it's good enough. She's drawn a great shot.
Yeah, well done. Quick question there, is the YouTube channel and Facebook available to catch up when the game's on the BBC? Yes, so this is the last game for myself and the rest of the team on the stream with Optical Media. From tomorrow, BBC will take control. They have their own commentators, David Corkill and Sean, two fabulous players in their own right. David's been there, done it before. Sean, her CV speaks for itself as well, doesn't it? But yes, the feed on Facebook and YouTube will continue all the way through. So if you're out and about doing your shopping and you want to just dip in or dip out and have a little look, you could do that. That's totally acceptable.
It's great now we've got all these different platforms to watch our sport on. And yeah, Sean's fantastic in commentary with Corky. All that experience. Great to see her back playing for England as well, indoor. Very, very good skip. Good leader.
Always helps when you've been there and you've done it and you've experienced it. You know, that's a huge thing, isn't it, when you're commentating? Which is why I like to get the players involved.
Yes, right.
I just turn up, bring the show on air, and let you experts explain the game.
Experts.
Agree.
Well, you know what? I think Julie's really finding her range here. I mean, she's really coming into this game. Laura needs to close his head down, if she can.
Very unlucky. It's in a receiving position.
I think that's probably about the fourth or fifth ball that Lauren's played on that backhand this way that has just held off with that little bit of weight. There is an inside line there. She hasn't quite caught that yet. It's easily done. Easily done. We saw Annie Dunham earlier make probably the same error, just be slightly wide on that hand. There's someone that is absolutely fantastic. Oh, good try, Julie. Someone that's been absolutely fantastic this tournament. I want to give a big shout out to Annalise Dunham. I've never seen anyone turn up a potters for the first year and just be so natural on that green. I thought she was a bit unlucky against Catherine, to be honest, and she should be so proud of her performance. I'm sure everyone in England's really proud of her. Oh, Lauren's for the chipper elbow.
Two shots, Julie Forrest.
So a double for Julie.
Set score 0-6 after 3 ends.
Quick question, how many seconds is the portable rink running at? So on average, slightly slower, 16 seconds roughly. And the way we time that is anybody can time that. So the minute you get a 27 meter length jack, so we get one, this is
that length, 24 meters.
The minute the ball leaves the player's hand, stop clock. And the minute it stops, bang on 27 meters, stop it. And that's That's just how it's done. It's done worldwide like that.
That's doesn't, right.
It's very simple. It doesn't need a shoot or anything like that.
That's a wider line, and Lauren's enjoyed it. Look at that. She's tossed it out. Got really nice float back. Brilliant, Lauren.
Nominate toucher.
Very, very good. It's a very short jacket playing right there.
Yes, 1 inch in front of Jack Eye. It's now following Julie. It's
6-0 down, not panicking.
3.5 inches short.
Just focusing what she needs to do. Any other youngsters out there coming through? I know we've actually had a British Isles Championship, Jason, under-18s, I think, have been on. And I just want a big shout-out to any of those youngsters that have been competing for all our countries. I think Lauren's brother might actually have been playing for Wales, I think. Tracy mentioned that to me. And Lauren's mum, Tracy and Sue, were here watching her. And they've just been fantastic. I think they've had a really good time. We were all up dancing last night.
Yes, with me.
Yes. She's out on that line again. Here we go. Now, can Lauren group? Good effort.
1 minute.
Bit of flight path there. Yeah, here we go. Release forehand bowl on the ball. Nope.
Click, click, clatter.
I wonder if Lauren's ball's staying on the green there. If it is, it's still the deepest back and it's close to the spot. Closer to the spot. Is it still on, Jace? That red
yes.
ball.
Yeah,
yes,
yeah,
it is.
Still on, definitely.
That's quite handy, actually.
I love the way you pointed at it with your pen that nobody could see.
Here we go. Needs to get down.
It's into
tuck
two.
Behind.
It's down, it's two.
If it drops, maybe.
Close, Julie. Time record. Julie has 1 time out remaining.
Oh, there we are. Jane Type is on the comments. She's saying Kellen, Lauren's brother was in the under-18s. Ah, thanks, Jane. Appreciate that. Jane knows everything that's going on in Welsh bowls, so glad I've got you to keep me right. Yeah, so as I was saying, there's an under-18 championship that's been going on. All those youngsters, all that enthusiasm. It's brilliant for the sport. But I'm sure loads of them will be tuning in to watch Lauren tonight. She's only 20, right?
Yes.
So she is their generation. She is the one they are watching here to see how she's going to do. And what an inspiration she is. Wow, great bowling, Lauren. Just put her back in the set.
2 red, measure for 3.
Oh, easy
yes.
In.
Yes, not quite close that one.
Two shots, Lauren gone.
Oh, good end.
set score 2-6 after four ends. Jack length 28 metres.
That's a good start, Lisa.
Yeah, very good.
Julie, we're starting to take control of the second set, just controlling the length of that jack. It looked like moving the mat around doing it, and it just threw her, I think, the last end there. We're quite sure Lauren hopped on it. Close here, though, Julie. Oh, she's going to stay up. Not quite. Great opener, though.
Quick question there, Andrew Ward. What bowls is Lauren using? She's using the, it's called biased bowls. It's the first time they've appeared this year on the portable ring. Well, Lauren, jack first. Well done.
Pretty easy to come to potters and be tentative on those sorts of shots, right? You've got one, do you want to do my, you know, and here she is, she's turning the white first. Just a real sign of confidence. But it's open now. Here comes Julie. Just over. Give it
one
a chance
red.
Though. Well, well, well. Oh, get it nice. Oh. I don't know. Maybe. Maybe hang on. Well, Julie, when are you going to spring this? Close.
Oh,
very
look at
close.
This. Look at this.
What
oh.
a shot.
Lucky.
Oh, I'm lucky. Just too far.
Just looking to what we call a full draw. So that means you're playing the draw, but you're guaranteeing the length.
Yep.
Makes absolutely fabulous
Lauren
contact.
Down.
Probably Lovely. 6 inches too much.
Yeah, and she cracked an egg that unfortunately didn't quite make the omelette she was looking for.
So let's go 3-6 after five ends.
I mean, at this level, when you look at the World Championships, it's just those kind of contacts are what may win you, what may lose you. a world title, aren't they?
They are.
6 or 7 inches or so, that is a big difference.
They can be, but the real difference is what you do with your next bowl. Everybody gets a bad cut. Everyone gets a bad result. It's how you respond to it straight after. That's the difference between, I think, winning the games or not. It's how rattled are you going to be. Julie Forrest, she isn't going to be rattled by that. She's just going to go, actually, I did the shot I wanted to do. It just didn't go right.
Correct.
She'll be thinking, right, I did it. I did what I wanted to do. And that's the difference, I think. It's not the result, it's the response to the result. Here she comes. Here we go. Rest my case.
Again, it's just two great opening bowls. She's nearly got this back, you know.
She's got it.
Oh.
She's got it.
No play.
Got it tipped. In the crowd. Can't quite see it on camera, but this very full crowd I know on the other side, which is great for the girls.
One red.
She's
wow.
Here again.
Fantastic.
Two red.
I just love seeing this kind of play. We've got so many top-class lady players and a lot of people slightly under that. I always believe it's just getting the break at the right
mm-hmm.
time.
Mm-hmm. How's Julie looking?
She's
giving
it
a chance.
1-2.
Oh, classy, 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 all the way. Lovely two cards. You know, going back to what you say there, Jason, like Lauren has really benefited from being part of the Welsh domestic system. And indoor this year, they've changed the rules whereby the men's championship team on the weekend, you know, we were talking, Lindsay asked us a question earlier around competition pathways. Well, Wales have opened it up. Now, women can play with men in their championships on the weekend. So Lauren has benefited from that. There'll be generations that come after her that will benefit from playing top level league domestically on a weekend with the men. And I just want to say, like, huge congratulations to the Welsh Indoor Bowling Association for being brave enough to take that step. It's not an easy thing to do to change the competition structure in your country. And I think that's the first time that's happened in the UK.
Good.
Where and long may it continue.
I used to say, it's funny you should say that because...
One shot, Julie Forrest.
Even if you come off a green, you've been absolutely battered. Don't come off disheartened. What you need to come off...
That's got 3-7 after 6 ends.
What do I take from that? What do I learn from that? And, you know, I played for so many years where some of my team will let go of the bowl. And we all know if it's a bad bowl or not. They'll play a tight bowl and they'll turn the back on it. And I say, watch it. Watch it till it finishes. Because at one point, the jack may end up in that position. And you've learned something.
Yeah. Yeah. I would say that the addition of the women to the league, though, is not
meters.
Just good for the women. I actually think it's good for the sport.
Yes.
And I'm sure there'll be clubs out there, men's teams, that are really benefiting from having the stronger women competing with them every Saturday, every week.
And we see it in England. We see a lot of times where they're trying to change a team format because certain clubs don't have enough men or don't have enough women.
Mm-hmm.
And you say, well, if you join the two together, then there'll be more than enough.
Yeah.
But like you say, it just takes that brave person to make that decision.
Yeah.
And then the buy-in from the teammates.
That's right. We've got some brave people running the sport in Wales, and I recently joined the board of Bowls Wales, and some brave people in there too, and really excited to see where the sport goes in our country over the next 10 years. Well done, Lauren. I think with people like Lauren coming through, it's in safe hands on the green for sure. Well, for Julius, it's all really now about match management. You know, she's four shots up. This is N7. She really just needs to keep this tight.
One red.
Very close. Well played, Julie Forrest. Well done.
One green.
All right.
Not far away. No. Just slightly short, is it?
No, I think she's got it.
Well played.
This is a great game of bowls.
Fantastic. Really interesting. As I said earlier, real gulf in experience, but no gulf in talent.
Well, Lauren, this is the chance you want on N7. Draw again for a three. And that will be a huge change to this set. Deep breath, nice and relaxed. Off you go again. Now, what's the mannerism? I think she likes it.
Yeah. She's playing it safe. And you know what? I actually don't blame her. If she'd touched the jack just the wrong way and it flopped, it would have been one or two, maybe. But I think two is good. Two is a reasonable result. It is two, isn't it, Jason, that she's got there?
Two shots, still on going.
Yeah, I mean, she's within two now. She really needs more in the set to take the game. It really wasn't worth it.
Score 5-7 after 7
ends. Just over. She's a smart girl for 20 out
she
there,
is,
right?
Yes.
You know, she knows exactly what she's doing.
At length, 28 and a half metres.
This is a really big end. What's Julie got? It's a good start. Very good start. Gives us up the hand a bit as well.
Just slightly up. Can she get to the jack? Probably sat down for shot.
I do miss the volley pops, Jason. I miss when, you know, when we used to be able to see the discs. to see how many shots we were up or down, or
lollipops.
The lollipops. I used to call them the lollipops.
Well played here.
Yes.
Fantastic.
Brilliant. First talk about that stage. It's just like match management, right?
Yes,
she knows she just needs one this end, Julie. And then Lauren's left trying to get a full count. She loses one. Lauren only needs one. It's a huge end, that one shot.
Just slightly up, 18 inches, that's all. People are asking there, does the World Bowls Tour have slightly different builds to World Bowls? We do. Yes, it's, there's Ivy. Well, the panda's got a different flower in its hair. Panda's called Robert after Robert Paxton. Did you
really?
Hear?
Yeah. Really?
Yeah, she's called it Robert after Robert Paxton.
Really?
Yeah, I'm not sure who's more curious about that, me or him.
Or the panda. sorry, Rob.
Yeah, but we do have our own rules. I mean, we have to, we're aware we need to change and adapt our rules for broadcast.
Yeah.
And quite rightly so, when you're trying to promote the sport on a huge stage using a national television company, that's where you have just ever so slight different rules, not many. Touch. Oh, unlucky. And we always review those rules every year. Can we do things better? Are we doing things wrong? I think bowls should be like any business. How do we need to change to stay current?
Almost 2 feet past jack high.
And I think we've still got a lot to do. When I say that, I think we've got a lot to do as a bowling community. The bowling community needs to be a bit more positive about their own sport that they so-called love.
Yeah.
Well played, Julie.
Yes. Very, very, very good. That's a guaranteed tiebreak now.
Ooh, it is.
Worthy match of a tiebreak, I think.
I think so as well.
You know, on any other day, you'd be putting your money on Julie for this tiebreak. But as I've said all along, the way Lauren's been playing, it's be interesting to see how this one plays out. And of course, I'm interested because I'm playing the winner of this one, Jason.
Of course, yeah. Of course, yes. I wondered why you've written 47 pages of notes.
He's kidding everyone. I really haven't. I've written 50.
Kerry Ann's game management book is the only book bigger than David Bolt's.
That's really funny.
And his sells for £2.
Julie Forrest.
I am known as a bit of the geek, aren't I? Everyone thinks he's a geek.
Let's go 5-9 off eight ends.
Here we go.
Tack length, 27 and a half
meters. There's a question here. I actually think it's a great question because I can imagine if you were only watching this online, They want to know where the commentary box is. So as you can see online, and when you're looking online, you can see there's a small crowd on one side and a big crowd on the other. So on the side where the big crowd is, we're at one end, almost in line with the big...
End of the big stand.
The end of the big stand, yeah, up high. So we're looking right down on the rink, but at an angle. So it's a bird's eye view from the side of a tree.
Yeah, I mean, if this was rink two in your club, we're probably level with rink five.
Yeah, yeah.
But we're high enough to see most of it. That's the good thing. The downside is we're high enough for everybody to see us. Mm. Especially when you change your top.
Well, what a star from Julie here. I mean, look at this. Gone longer. And she's nailed it, pretty much.
That's all she has to do.
Yep.
Just keep matching Lauren's bowls.
Well, still plenty of room here, though, to draw this off. It's a good foot there. Here we go, Lauren. How are you doing?
How are you doing?
One green.
Hi. I've just been pulled up there. I've been commentating on these last few balls, like it's the beginning of the tiebreak, and it isn't. It's actually still the second set there, Jason.
It is. It's the last end. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Sorry, everyone. A bit of brain fog menopause there. I'm hoping you can forgive me.
Of course. It's gone a bit nearer. So, still a forehand little tag on the jack there. Tag it back, just a nice little three. Put Julie under pressure. Did she get the last bit?
Close. Oh, that's a shot, that's for sure.
Two shots long gone.
Just the two. Forrest, but she did that really, really well.
Yeah, she did it great.
Because what she thought there was, is I don't think I'm going to be able to win that set, so I'm going to just keep me draw pace and not play anything stupid.
Yeah.
So we're going to go into a tie break, everybody. Before we go into a tie break, we'd like to thank once again Imagine Cruising for sponsoring the World in Doubles Championships. Let's have a little look at what they have to offer us.
Length 25 metres.
And as it says, if you fancy discovering the world, why not do it with a 5% cheeky discount code BOWLS24.
I'm doing it, by the way. I know, Ian, you're probably watching this game. I haven't had a chance to talk to you yet, but I'm going to do it live in front of everyone. I've been looking at it. It looks awesome. Next year we're going. We can't go this year, but we're definitely doing it next year. I've been actually looking at the cruises. They look amazing, Jason.
They certainly do.
The deals are fantastic.
I think with Imagine Cruising is they book the best cruise lines, they book the best trains, you know, it is that luxury holiday where you may do once or twice in a lifetime.
But the prices are fantastic as well, everyone. You really should take a look. Yeah. Ian, if you're listening, we're going. Right. Here we go. Now, we really are into a tie break. Julie's started really strong.
Yeah, well done. Tie breaks are very different, of course, because it doesn't matter how many you score in an end. You can score four, you can score one. It's still the same. It just ends one. So sometimes you see an awful lot of aggressive play or sometimes defensive play.
Yep.
Oh, fabulous. Well played.
That has been first, yeah.
100.
I'm just interested to see what Julie does here. What do you think she's going to do, Jason? Do you think she's going to try and flick this bowl off or just roll it? Get the jack to hers.
I think she'd probably play a bit quicker. Yeah. Although she's certainly good enough to draw that. I think she'll play a little bit quick, open it up, or if she does get that nice little flick away from the jack,
yep,
that puts Lauren straight away under pressure.
Yep.
Timeout called. Julie, there's one timeout remaining.
Lauren's family members there. You can see the little
Tracy and Sue.
Are they Welsh tops? They're football tops? Are
yes. They? I think they're one's a rugby top.
No, I'm not very good at football, sorry. That's a bit mean. Alex Kelly said, "High Tower were but the Titanic for you." Slightly underneath, how's
she's
your
got
fortune?
It.
Ran with it, but it's going out.
Do you know what? As that was running with it, I thought she was going to get a toucher literally on the way.
Jack's
knock,
out.
Yeah, but knock at the yeah. jack back in. It was really interesting the way it was rolling.
It's a good hit.
Great hit.
It's what you call a hit and recover shot. So hit it first, then recover where you last.
Yep. Marla's got two, Julie's got one. That's actually a very, very good start from Laura. You know, she's not used to playing to these balls as well. It's really easy to forget. You know, we watch these players so experienced all the time playing to the boards. Laura's never done that before.
No.
And then she just stood on the mat, out she went, no bother at all.
Nope. First down, Lauren Gowen.
So, advantage for Lauren, opening tie break end. Lauren, where are you going to go? She kept the mic back.
Length 28 metres.
Well, this match is definitely not over yet. You certainly would still think that Julie's got something in her ear. She's got to pull something out. But what an outstanding performance from Lauren Gowen, regardless of the outcome of this game. And look, here she comes again. Julie, well, you passed, and that's what you want to do, Jason, right? Even if
yes.
you're not on top of it, you're giving yourself options.
I mean, if Lauren manages to win here, I mean, it will be an upset. It won't be a shock because her ability is too good for it to be a shock, and Julie would respect that as well. But on this particular rink, you know, I can't remember the last time Julie lost first round.
She lost to be in the semi-final, so she definitely got through one round last year. So that's two Welshies poor Julie's come up against two consecutive years. But, I mean, anyone can win on their day here, Jason. All of us know that. We all respect each other. But look, here's Julie. That's what you expect from her.
One green.
She's got an Al Lawrence in. Gonna have to do something here. Actually, I think Julie might have played me first round last year and lost.
Did she?
I think it was first round. Yes, it was.
Well, she's holding on here.
She's holding on here, though.
3 seconds for Lauren.
No, she's played so well in the mixed pairs as well. She's been a real on-form player for the last 4 or 5 days. Well, the last 3 decades, actually.
Needs to fall down, because if it falls down, that'll be enough to force Lauren into the draw. I think it's probably second anyway. So I think Lauren just has that. Yes, it's fell now. So two green it is. I think Lauren just needs to draw this against the bat bowl.
It's a good bad bowl, that one, really. It's a pretty good guide out there for Lauren.
Time out called. Lauren has 4 timeouts remaining.
Well, if she can nail this, this could be her through to the semi-final of the World Championships.
Not far away, Lauren.
She switches her hand.
She's got the gap.
Yeah. Oh, what an effort.
Unbelievable.
You know how brave, that was so brave. You know, a lot of people thinking, oh, I would stick to the same hand. I've only got to really flop in off the back bowl and I can throw the shot. No, she just switches over and uses the guide on the other side. And so brave and great weight. Probably deserved to get the shot out of that.
She certainly did. She played a great bowl for nothing. Bowl or jack, she got the gap.
Yeah.
That's just.
And you can see her thinking at the back of the ring. That little flick of the hair. Yep, here we go.
So Julie has the control of the jack and the mat for the last end. Lauren will have that advantage of the last bowl. Now, will she need to send it or not? Let's see. So the rules change on the last end of the tie break. It's the only end where we can have a dead end. So the players are allowed to nominate to kill the end, which means send it out the sides of the confines of the ring. Rather than going on to a tie break, it will be killed. Can nominate with all 4 bowls. They can only ever kill it once. So once it's killed, that's it. It's done and dusted. No idea which way this is going to go. Might even come down to a tiny bit of luck.
Well, Jason, look at this.
Fabulous.
Oh, didn't grab it solid.
Here again, because she just sneaking through.
Switched over hands, still good a shot. As we say in Wales, arfechog.
What was that?
Excellent. Excellent. Arfechog.
Arfechog?
Yeah. Not ara. Arfechog.
Is that spelled with four L's?
Yes.
I got told off from
time of course.
I've seen Clenethley as Lionelli.
Oh, my word, Jason.
So, Julie, big bowl. You never want to save it to your last bowl. Well, Julie.
What a line she's
got. Doesn't want the gap.
Oh, wow. Wow, wow, wow. Even a little rub off that belly onto the jack.
She played very good pace, didn't she?
She had to give it the chance.
Very good pace. Solid on that ball.
You called it, Jason. You said this end might come down with a little bit of luck. That could be it. Let's see.
There are so many options with that 18 inches. Sit the shot ball, get to the jack.
Anything.
If you're underneath, run back off the short ball.
To be honest, she played it perfect.
Won't be getting any lottery numbers off her, that's for certain.
Nope.
Lauren will want to really close this down. Front toucher.
Well, she might be putting a little blocker in. Not sure that's the best shot, Lauren. First time you've really failed this game. Oh, no. At this point.
Well, Julie. Here we go. Last bowl to stay in the Ladies World Match Play.
Well.
Line's good again.
On a line again.
How's
Julie
your look?
Forrest.
She's got the gap, has she?
No, she's got the jack.
She's got it.
What a shot, Julie Forrest. That is why she's a legend, everyone. Right there.
She played exactly the same ball with a foot less pace, which allowed it to
class.
Get back to the jack.
Absolute class.
I thought she was getting that gap, but
nope.
Just slight less weight. Didn't
well, Lauren, you've got a shot on here. Let's see what you've got, lovely girl.
Time out called. Lauren has 3 timeouts remaining.
Whole of Wales is on the edge of their seat.
So, how's the nerves?
I think the nerves will be fine, but this is a some hard shot she's got on this tricky backhand.
She's just underneath, unfortunately.
Oh, wow. What a game, girls.
Wow. Just 2 feet short of the pace that she needs. And what a fantastic game there. But Julie Forrest really showed her commitment and her experience into the sport. Alex, her daughter, is absolutely delighted. Thank you for joining me this evening, Kate.
Pleasure. I hope Lauren's proud of herself. She really should be. We're all proud of her in Wales.
Yep. Well, everybody, so we're going to have a quick look at what we have for tomorrow. So tomorrow morning, live on the BBC, 10 o'clock. Wow. What a way to start the BBC coverage. Paul Foster, MBE, one of the best players in the Northern Hemisphere, takes on Aaron Sheriff, probably one of the best players in the Southern Hemisphere. That's going to be a cracker. 1 o'clock, Stuart Anderson and Darren Burnett. Paul Foster, Jason Pines, World Open Pairs Final. That is going to be absolutely outstanding. 3 o'clock, roughly, current world champion Jamie Walker takes on the Scottish qualifier of Ian McLean. He is a bronze medalist at the Commonwealth Games. So what a lineup we have for you tomorrow. Well, that's us done here at the World Bowls Tour. So on behalf of myself, Emily, Gray, Mervyn Cole, Kerry, and everybody that's helped us in the commentary box, and on behalf of all our streaming team at Optical Media, thank you very much for joining in. Thank you for your support as always. Join the BBC tomorrow for some cracking bowls all the way until Sunday. So until tomorrow, bye-bye for now.